So to construct recombinant DNA, it is important to analyze size of different DNA segments, and how we are going to analyze those segments of DNA is with the help of this gel electrophoresis. So basically what will happen in this gel electrophoresis system is that DNA fragments, we know that DNA fragments are negatively charged. So we write it first that DNA fragments are negatively charged. So what will happen to these negatively charged DNA? How we are going to analyze the size? So what will happen when we will pass electric current? So it will move towards positive charge or anode. So from negative charge, we are placing DNA segments at cathode point. So DNA are placed at cathode, which is negatively charged, and while passing the electric current, it will move towards the positive charge. So how it will move? We will be using a matrix which is known as agarose gel. So agarose gel is basically the matrix which is used. What will happen with this agarose gel? So basically it is a gel which is poured over DNA fragments to make a well-like structure over different segments of DNA which we are using to analyze. So I will draw the structure, how it will appear. So suppose this is a chamber where we are going to perform this experiment, and this is a negative charge point, which is cathode point, and this is anode point. So how agarose gel will create a well-like structure over the DNA fragments, we will see here. So suppose this is DNA fragment 1, DNA fragment 2, DNA fragment 3, DNA fragment 4, DNA fragment 5. So we will create a gel. With the help of agarose gel, we will create a well. And with the help of this gel, we are differentiating these each segments of DNA also. So basically agarose gel is a porous kind of gel, and when we are passing electric current through these pores, these DNA fragments will start moving. So it will move when electric current will pass from negative towards positive point. So in this experiment, we observe that from the pores of this agarose gel, the DNA fragments which are of smallest size, the DNA fragments of smallest size will move faster and farther, while the larger piece of DNA will not be able to move at farther point. They will remain somewhere like here, here. Suppose this is the smallest fragment. So it will move farther and faster. While a piece of DNA which are of different size, we can see that this piece of DNA is larger. So it will not be able to move much farther. It will remain somewhere in between. So this is how we identify or analyze the different DNA segments. We see that it is moving from negative ends toward the positive with the porous by passing the pores of agarose gel. And we have seen the smallest piece of DNA is moving farther and faster. So according to our need, we extract this DNA, and this extraction of DNA from this gel piece is known as elution. So the extraction of DNA fragments from the gel piece is known as elution. So elution means the fragments extraction from gel piece. So according to our need, we extract and we use it for recombinant DNA. So DNA is actually is not visible with our naked eyes. So how we are going to analyze it, how we are going to visualize it with the help of stain, which is known as ethidium bromide. And ethidium bromide in the presence of or with the exposure of UV light we are able to visualize the segments of DNA. DNA fragments are visual and appearance is like orange color. So this is all from the gel electrophoresis. In my next video, I will discuss about cloning vector. So if you like this video, please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.